Now that we know what isotonic solutions are and also what constituents are sweat, it's important to know how much athletes should rehydrate with both during and post exercise. So the gold standard here is a sweat rate calculation. Now some important guidelines before I run you through an example is that one, you should use a well calibrated weighing machine kept on a hard surface, and athletes should try and wear minimal clothing, keep themselves completely dry of any sweat or anything like that so that they get an accurate reading of their body weight. Now for this example, first we need to define what the exercise duration is. So for this example, this athlete was training for 2 hours. Starting weight that we have is 50 kgs, so it's a 50 kg athlete who's training for 2 hours. Now when they ended exercise, their weight was 48 kgs. That means they've lost 2 liters or 2 kgs of fluids, right? We also took into account how much fluids they had during training. So they had 1 liter, which means approximately 1 kg of weight added to their body. Now that gives us a total loss of 3 kgs in 2 hours. Now 3 kgs in 2 hours would mean 3 liters in 2 hours. That would mean 1.5 liter per hour. So this athlete has a sweat rate of 1.5 liters per hour. So they would need to rehydrate with 1.5 liters of an isotonic solution during exercise. And post exercise, they should have 1 time to 1.5 times this fluid loss. So all athletes watching this video, this is the gold standard to rehydrate during exercise for improved performance. So you can do your own sweat rate calculation and follow these guidelines to hydrate optimally, which would then improve your performance.